Blessed is the kingdom of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
In peace let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace from above and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For peace of the whole world, for the stability of the holy churches of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy house and for those who enter it with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all pious and Orthodox Christians, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Archbishop and Father Savas, not the Honorable Presbyter, for the Diaconate of Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Thank you.
and peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Commemorating our all holy, pure, most blessed and glorious Lady, the Blessed and Ever Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commend ourselves, one another, and our whole life unto Christ our God. For you are God, our good and love mankind. To you we offer up glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
All illumined by the Holy Spirit, irrigated by the living waters that the Savior provides, O allotted saint, when you had drunk of the waters of salvation, to those who thirsted you shared them abundantly. O great martyr and apostle's equal, Saint Fortini, to Christ our God, pray further me, entreating him to save our souls.
Wisdom arise.
Come, let us worship and bow down before Christ. Save us, O Son.
Adios, 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 Adios Through he who does not love his brother, for this is the message which you have heard from the beginning, that we should love one another and not be like Cain, who was of the evil one and murdered his brother. And why did he murder him? Because his own deeds were evil and his brother's righteous. You no longer, brethren, that the world hates you. We know that we have passed out of death into life because we love the brethren. He who does not love of death, and anyone who hates his brother is a murderer, and you know him, the murderer has eternal life abiding in him. But this we know, by this we know love, that he laid his life for us, and we ought to lay down our lives for the brethren. But if anyone has the world's goods and sees his brother in need, yet closes his heart against him, how does God's love abide in him? Little children, let us not love in word or speech, nor in deed or in truth, but this we shall know that we are of the truth. We reassure our hearts before him whenever our hearts condemn us, for God is greater than our hearts, and he knows everything. Beloved, if our hearts do not condemn us, we have confidence before God. And we receive from him whatever we ask.
The righteous shall flourish like a palm tree and shall grow like a cedar in Lebanon. Those who are planted in the house of the Lord shall flourish in the courts of our God. Wisdom, arise. Let us hear the holy gospel. Peace be unto all. The reading is from the holy gospel according to Mark. Let us be attentive. At that time, Judas Iscariot, who was one of the 12, went to the chief priests in order to betray him to them. And when they heard it, they were glad and promised to give him money. And he sought an opportunity to betray him. And on the first day of unleavened bread, when they sacrificed the Passover lamb, his disciples said to him, "Where will you have us go and prepare for you to eat the Passover?" And he sent two of his disciples and said to them, "Go into the city, and a man carrying a jar of water will meet you. Follow him, and wherever he enters, say to the householder, 'The teacher says, where is my guest room? Where am I to eat the Passover with my disciples?' He will show you a large upper room, furnished and ready, there prepared for us." And the disciples set out and went to the city and found it as he had told them, and they prepared the Passover. And when it was evening, he came with the 12. And as they were at table eating, Jesus said, "Truly I say to you, one of you will betray me, one who is eating with me." They began to be sorrowful and to say to him one after another, "Is it I?" He said to them, "It is one of the 12, one who is dipping bread into the dish with me. For the Son of Man goes as it was written of him. But woe to that man by whom the Son of Man is betrayed. It would have been better for that man if he had not been born." And as they were eating, he took bread and blessed and broke it and gave it to them and said, "Take, this is my body." And he took a cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, and they all drank of it. And he said to them, "This is my blood of the new covenant, which is poured out for many. Truly I say to you, I shall not drink again of the fruit of the vine until that day when I drink it new in the kingdom of God." And when they had sung a hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives, and Jesus said to them, "You will all fall away, for it is written, I will strike the shepherd, and the sheep will be scattered. But after I am raised up, I will go before you to Galilee. Peter said to him, even though they all fall away, I will not. And Jesus said to him, truly I say to you, this very night before the cock crows twice, you will deny me five times. But he said vehemently, if I must die with you, I will not deny you. And they all said the same. And they went to a place which was called Gethsemane, and he said to his disciples, sit here while I pray. And he took with him Peter and James and John, and began to be greatly distressed and troubled. And he said to them, my soul is very sorrowful, even to death. Remain here and watch. And going a little farther, he fell on the ground and prayed that if it were possible, the hour might pass from him. And he said, Abba, Father, all things are possible to you. Remove this cup from me, yet not what I will, but what you will. And he came and found them sleeping, and he said to Peter, Simon, are you asleep? Could you not watch 1 hour? Watch and pray that you may not enter into temptation. The spirit is indeed willing, but the flesh is weak. And again he went away and prayed, saying the same words. And again he came and found them sleeping, for their eyes were very heavy, and they did not know what to answer him. And he came the third time and said to them, are you still sleeping and taking your rest? It is enough. The hour has come. The Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners. Rise, let us be going. See, my betrayer is at hand.
Glory to you, Lord. Glory to you.
Please be seated. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Christ is in our midst. The Lord is gracious to us today, brothers and sisters, that we have just as many gathered visibly behind the altar as we do out of the altar. And so this is a blessing that I get to see when I turn, smiling faces. It's a good thing. As we commemorate the feast of Saint Fortuny, I am conflicted only because it is the church, the patriarchate, did not give us this reading today. There is a reading for Saint Fortuny. We know she was by the well. You know, we know that gospel that we hear on the post-paschal gospels. We look forward to that day. But the church in her wisdom did not give us the readings for the saint as the main readings of the day. The church, the patriarchate gave us the readings of this day, Tuesday of the Meat Fair Week. And it's good for us to keep in our brains that as we are commemorating Saint Fortuny, who was not just this woman who brought her entire village to Christ, she has a story even beyond that. Her post-resurrection, her post-Pentecost story after she was baptized is really phenomenal. But we find ourselves in this period of time preparing ourselves for Great Lent, this Triodion period, this period where we're allowed to remember what it is that we're about to go through. And this, these weeks are the last weeks that we're going to hear gospels unless there's a feast day, until, you know, until Lent. And I mean, until Holy Week. We're not going to hear another gospel during the week. Saturday and Sundays are exceptions. We're not going to hear another gospel during the week unless it's a feast day, until Holy Week. Because the entire readings of the Lenten period are not about preaching the good news at that point. It's about contrition. It's about repentance. And these gospels that we are hearing now are the ones that are supposed to knock us off of our feet. These are the ones. These are the ones that are supposed to say, oh boy. It's that time of year. And I don't say that with a sigh, but I say that excitedly. This is really a wonderful time for us. But this gospel today is one that, you know, as I was preparing for this day, I was like, oh my goodness, look at how long this gospel is. You know, like, I couldn't believe it. But then I read it, and I reread it, and I noticed something in the Gospel of Mark that I've never noticed before. And it's just one of those things. It's just one of those things that just kind of jumps off the page. Maybe my brothers behind are the ones that have noticed this, and they'll beat me over the head whenever I go back inside and I never saw it. But it's right in the Gospel of Mark, right? Right when they're gathering together. And they're all questioning who's going to betray Christ, which is, by the way, evidence that Judas was there. Judas was there at that supper, because if he wasn't there, they would have said, oh, well, we know who it is. He was there. People always try to cheat. He left early, fine, but he was there. And so, they're all questioning themselves, and Peter's going, no, not me. Everyone else is going to fall away from you, not me. I'm not going to be the one. I'm going to follow you, even in heaven and earth will pass away, and all the rest of these things are going to follow you to my death. Right? That's what Peter says. And then 2 hours later, Jesus sees him, and he's out. Down for the count. And the Gospel of Mark talks about how it's Peter, James, and John that were there falling asleep. But when Jesus comes out, he doesn't speak to James and John. He doesn't talk to those two. He says, Simon, you couldn't wait with me? You know, and you're reading that, you're going, you just said how you were going to stay with him to the death, and you couldn't wait with him for 1 hour. That's us. That's us. We all talk about how we would die for something. Oh, I would die for this, or I would die for Christ, or I would die for the Lord, or I would die for the church, or I would die for whatever noble thing that we would talk about. And my response has always been, it's funny, since I was even a teenager, my response has always been, that's nice. You would die for this. Would you live for it? How much is it worth to you? If the opportunity to die never comes, would you live your life like this was all that mattered? And the question I have to keep asking myself, would I do that? Am I capable of doing that? We hear a lot of lip service paid to all of these heroes that just kind of summon it up at a time that they needed. But heroes aren't just made heroes in many cases. Heroes are trained so that when the crunch time comes, they focus. Myself, I can tell you squeeze me, I lose heart. Unfortunately, it's me. But that's the motive. That's the motive of Great Lent. The motive of Great Lent is to prepare us for squeezing crunch time. So that whenever we need to find the Lord in the valley of our sorrows, we know how to reach out to Him. We know how to find our contrition. You know how to find to connect in the most ultimate relationship in the world. That was St. Philippe. That was her. She had spent so much of her time not doing that. She had one encounter with Christ and then completely changed her life. It wasn't watch with me 1 hour. She made her life's practice bringing people to Christ. Her village was just the start. She's not just a great martyr. She's equal to the apostles' great martyr for what they need. She was so in love with Christ, it didn't matter who it was. And her children were the same way. She had a son that was a soldier that did the same thing while he was even in his army, bringing people. She was so in love with Christ, and the rest of her life was so enthralled and encompassing, bringing people to him, that when the time came for her to be brought before Emperor Nero, because he was the emperor at the time, and she was brought before him, he asked her, "What are you here for?" She said, "Because I'm going to bring you to Christ too. I came here to bring you to Christ." He summoned her to execute her, but she didn't even see it that way. She came to bring him to Christ also. Of course, we know that he never came to Christ. And that her willingness to live for Christ, even at that moment, the only way she knew how to live for Christ was this way. That in living for this way, she ended up dying for Christ. After many, many tortures. She wasn't beheaded, by the way. She peacefully gave up her soul. But it was after many, many tortures. Things that I'm not going to recount. But it's important to watch and pray. It's important that as we boast sometimes, like St. Peter boasts, no, I'll never leave Christ. This is the time to recognize, you know what, maybe we do. And maybe we leave Christ more often than we would like to admit. And maybe now is the time to get that extra focus so that we can be like St. Philippe. Squeeze us and get focused. Squeeze us. Torture us. Ridicule us. And we will never leave Christ. That's the motive for today. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please let us rise and we will continue our divine prayer. Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
have
mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Wisdom, that ever guarded by your might, we may ascribe glory to you, to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, to the ages of ages.
Thank you.
house and for those who enter it with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
That the whole day may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us ask of the Lord. Guide and guardian of our souls and bodies, let us ask the Lord.
Have this, O Lord.
Pardon the
remission
of our sins and transgressions, let us ask the Lord.
Have this, O Lord.
For that which is good and beneficial for our souls and for peace for the world, let us ask the Lord.
Have this, O Lord.
Cherubim and seraphim, six when many eyes soared aloft upon their wings. eat, and this is my body, which is broken for you for the remission of sins.
Amen.
Drink of this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins.
Yeah.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Therefore, O Master, make smooth and beneficial for us all, whatever lies ahead of work for me, that we say what those who say, travel with those who travel, feel the same position for ourselves. Through the grace, compassion, and love for mankind of your only begotten Son, with whom you are blessed, together with your all holy, good, and life-creating Spirit, now and forever, and unto the ages of ages.
Thank you. will never be moved. He will be remembered forever.
Metaphor theopis Deus que agapis prosepeter, with the fear of God, with faith and with love, draw near. Sos Mateos, Colossus, che è noi siamo tempi della mia su. O God, save your people and bless your inheritance.
Joy to have behind her in case you are not aware of
who is behind the altar today. We'll go in order of seniority. Father, I believe Father John, you have seniority, no? Well, you do. Father Frank Milanese, who is co-celebrating with me from All Saints and Mary, you know who he is. Father John Kapja from St. Andrew OCA Parish in Mingo. Father Michael Zibart from our sister parish down in Martin's Ferry, the Locos PE, and of course, I almost said St. Andrew's, Father Andrew Nelko from St. Nicholas in Weir, the OCA Parish, right across from the Latter-day Saints, right across from the hospital. So it is a joy to have all of you here. We're gathering together just as a pre-Lenten way of getting our ducks in a row and talking about our region, see if we can do more for our people, for ourselves, for each other, and you know, maybe by ourselves we're a little weak, but together we are strong and mighty. So we're going to continue to keep doing that. We'll be gathering after this. There will be paráclisis tomorrow night here at 6 o'clock. Center of the Souls starts this weekend at our respective parishes. Good strength, folks. Good strength coming into Great Lent. So come forward and receive your blessing.
Souls and bodies, that these gifts be for healing of my body the averting of every evil, the illumination of the eyes of my heart, the peace of my spiritual powers, a faith unashamed, a love unfeigned, the fulfilling of wisdom, the observing of your commandments, the receiving of your divine grace, and the inheritance of your kingdom. Preserved by them in the holiness, may I always be mindful of your grace and no longer live for myself, but for you, our Master and Benefactor. May I pass from this life in the hope of eternal life and attain to the everlasting rest with the voices of your saints who feast are unceasing and their joy in beholding the ineffable beauty of your countenance is unending. For you, Christ our God, are the true joy and gladness of those who love you, and all creation praises you forever. Amen.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, to the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For that is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
All illumined by the Holy Spirit, you drink with great and ardent longing of the waters Christ the Savior gave unto you, and with the streams of salvation were you refreshed, which you abundantly gave to those who were athirst. Great martyr and true peer of the apostles, what do you mean? Entreat Christ God to grant great mercy unto us. Through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us.